Hi everybody, it's Michelle and I'm in the craft room today working on another beading project for you. This is probably my favorite jewelry making project that I've ever done. What we're going to be making today is beaded barefoot sandals. They're great in the summer at the pool or on the beach. They're really beautiful for beach weddings. I have made one ahead of time. And you're going to need two, obviously. And the way these work is you'll put your foot in that part so that it goes around your ankle. And this straight portion here will be on top of your foot. And you'll loop the little toe ring part around your second toe. And that makes foot jewelry that looks like you're wearing sandals, but still you're barefoot. I really, really love these. With this one, I've made this with metal beads. And if you're going to be going into the water, obviously you don't want to wear ones made with metal beads into the water because they may start to rust. If you're going to be wearing them into the water, you may want to stick with glass or acrylic beads, even plastic. Just something that's going to be safe in the water. So these would be more for just, you know, poolside on the beach, just not while you're in the water. But these are very versatile. You can make them with about any kind of bead you want. And if you'll hang around till the end of the video, I've got some more options that I'll show you of some different ways that you can do those. Okay, let's talk about the size on these. They are made with a stretchy cord. So they're kind of versatile. They'll fit a range of different sizes. But what I've found that fits most people is if you have an overall length of about 9 inches. And as you can see, that's about what we've got there. Now, to get that length, you're going to have to divide that up a little bit. You're going to go in three sections. And we'll talk about that with the different sizes before we get started on making the other one. The toe portion, this, like I said, it goes around your toe like a toe ring. On this portion, you're going to want a length of about 2.5 inches. Of beaded length. I do suggest measuring that instead of just counting beads, because with these little seed beads they do vary in size quite a lot. So if you count beads and they're all different sizes, you may end up with a different length on each one. So I always keep my ruler handy and measure that as I go. Okay, now for this, like I said, you'll have a 2.5 inch beaded length for the toe ring. Now that, once you loop that around and fold it in half there like that, you're really only getting 1.25 inches total length in the size of that. And then on the foot portion, this one I've got here, the portion on the top of the feet is about 2 inches. And with that length, that leaves you with a total here. Now you can see that it splits off into two sides after that. So those two sides, you're going to want about 5.75 inches long on each side. Okay, first thing we're going to need is our stretchy cord. That's what helps us to have that size versatility. I like to use the 0.5 millimeter because it's so thin that it's easy to fit through even the smallest beads. So I got this at Walmart, and that's really easy to find. So just have some of the 0.5 millimeter stretchy cord. And then I've got here some size 11 seed beads for the toe ring part. And then I've got some beads here that go along the foot portion of it for the decorative area. And then I've got a couple of butterflies This one here, the larger butterfly, measured through this part is about 9 millimeters. So it's about 11 if you measure to the tips of the wings. But we're only worried about this portion here, because through that hole is, that determines how much space it's going to take up in our beading strand. So we have that, and then a small butterfly too, and that one is just about 6 millimeters. Then we've got 1 8-millimeter bead, and that's a glass crackle bead in pink. And then we've got 2 of those in a 6 millimeter size. Now those I bought in a package that contained both different sizes in one package together that I found also at Walmart. And then for the ankle portion, we've got our size 6 seed beads. Now, like I said, you could use different beads on the foot portion. A lot of times it will look better if you have some larger beads on that area. And just remember to, you know, in our measurements we're using today, that's a 2-inch measurement on the foot portion and 5 3/4 on each side of the ankle portion. So you can do more, a larger or smaller area, whatever you want to do, and change it up on that foot portion. But just remember that you're going to have to adjust your ankle portion when you do. Just make sure that your overall finished sandal is about 9 inches in total length. But the toe portion, that measuring 2.5 inches for the toe portion to take up a total of 1 1/4 in the finished length, that part will remain the same probably in about any of the ones that you do. You only have to adjust the foot and ankle portions based on each other. Okay, we're going to get started. I've got my ruler here so that I can make sure my measurements are right as I go. And for our stretch cord, I'm going to start out with about 2 feet of that. And maybe a little extra for good measure, just to make sure we've got enough. Okay, now I'm going to thread that through 2 needles, one on either end. And that's kind of hard to do with that stretch cord, so I'm going to use my little threader here to help me. Okay, now we're going to have to work very carefully and just leave that tail hanging. We can't tie it in a knot or anything like that to secure it, because with the knot in it, it probably wouldn't fit through the hole in those very small beads. So, get my other needle. And the reason we need a needle on both ends is because we're going to have to run both ends through that foot portion together. I'll show you that when we get to that part. But we're going to have to work with this cord from both ends. Now I'm only going to need to work with one end while I'm doing the toe portion. So I'm going to bring in my little pin cushion here and just let it secure the other end of that for me. Okay, now we're going to start working toward our 2.5 inches of size 11 seed beads for the toe ring portion. And every once in a while you'll find one that won't quite fit over the needle, so we'll have to get rid of that one. That's going to block the rest of us. Now, I'm just using regular sewing needles here. It's probably part of the reason why that wouldn't go through there. The beading needles are a lot thinner and probably be a lot easier for you if you have those, but I don't have any. So I just tried to find the skinniest sewing needle that I could find that might fit through those. So every once in a while, I come across a smaller hole in a bead that won't go over it. Most of them do. That one won't go even over the tip, so we'll just get rid of that one. Quite there. Hanging up on me. I'm going to have to take all those off to get back to that one. Okay. Sometimes requires a little bit of patience. Like I said, if you've got the beading needles, you're probably not going to have that problem. It'll be much easier with those. Okay, that's, get that where you can see. Okay, now we've got 2.5 inches beaded for our toe portion. So, bring our two needles together and bring those down to the middle. Okay. And then we're done with our size 11 seed beads, so we can set those aside. Then we're going to take one of our size 6 seed beads, and we want both needles to go through that. And again, if you have the beading needles, you could probably put them both through at the same time. Save yourself a little bit of trouble. And then that makes your little toe ring portion like a little noose to go around your toe. Okay. Now we can start working on the portion for the top of the foot. And for that portion, both strands need to go through all of those beads. So just kind of take a minute to make sure that you've got enough of a tail on there that's not going to slip out of your needle and you'll lose all your beads, and that's going to be very frustrating. So I always try to hold on to the cord so that I make sure that doesn't slip through the needle. Okay, I'm going to bring in our first one that we made to remind me of my pattern that I did on there, so those will match. Okay, I've got my one seed bead there that locked our loop together, and then is our 8mm pink crackle glass. On some of these with the larger hole, I can get both my needles through there at once, and I'm going to try to do that anytime that I can because that makes it so much easier. And then we have another of our middle size 6 seed bead. Those went through too. That was great. Okay. And now our large butterfly. And those are not going to go through, so we're going to have to do those one at a time. Just make sure that you do get both going through there together so that those strands become as one on that foot portion. And then another size 6 seed bead. Try to find one that will let me put both needles through. There we go. And then we have one of our 6mm pink crackle beads. And that's not going to go through together. Just remember, if you have to do it one at a time, just keep in your mind that you're doing these as one strand on that foot portion. And then another size 6 seed bead. Kind of using those as spacers on this foot portion. Okay, now we're going to put our small butterfly. And again, we have to go one at a time. Careful to hold on to those cords so they don't slip out of your needle. There. Size 6 seed bead. And a 6mm crackle glass. And then one more of the size 6 seed beads. Okay. That is your foot portion there. Now, we're going to measure that. And I measured this portion, not counting that first seed bead that locked our loop. So just those. That gives us our 2 inches for the foot portion. Now we have to separate these and work in 2 different strands. So I'm going to pull in my pin cushion again and let that hold that side for me so I don't lose it. And then on this side, we're going to work toward our 5 3/4 inches of the number 6 seed beads. think maybe I could do this a little better out of my hand. So I'm going to try to hold on to those and see if I can do it that way. See where that's got us at in our measurement. Ooh, too long. Okay, let's see. I only needed about 5 3/4, so I don't need these. Just going to feed my needle back through those. Take those off. Okay. And that's our 5 3/4 inch measurement on that side. Get rid of that ruler now. We won't need the ruler anymore. We can just compare it to our other side and make sure we get them equal. Okay, I'm gonna let that hold that side for me. And string 5 3/4 inches on the other side. Lost my cord. Okay. I'm gonna have to re-thread that through my needle. I was afraid that would happen. As you get closer to the end, it's hard to keep that tail from slipping through. Okay. See what we've got. Just a few more beads. That looks about equal. So now we're ready to take our needles off. Set those aside. And we're just gonna tie our cord in the knot. Try not to pull a lot of that stretch out of it. We want to keep all that stretchy part in it for when we're wearing it. Just tie those in a knot. Bring it down as close to the beads as you can get it. Okay. Now that you've got your knot, there's your barefoot sandal. Okay. Now, on that knot, I'm just going to come in and put some glue on that to make sure that it holds. I'm just going to use a scrap of cardstock there and dot out a little E6000 on there so that I can dip into that with a toothpick, and then I'm only going to get as much as I need instead of having a big gob. Okay. Get a little bit of the E6000. Put it right on that knot. And then, after that glue sits up, we'll come back in and clip off our tails, and that's all you have to do. And there you've got your pair of barefoot sandals. You can make them with any design, any kind of beads, any colors. Match with your swimsuit, match with a beach wedding color scheme. You can personalize them any way that you want. Another one of my favorite pairs that I've made before are these with the clear and silver. I think those are very pretty. Now on these, the foot portion here was just a little bit longer than my 2 inches. So I just shortened the ankle portions so that I still have my overall 9-inch length. And then as long as you stay consistent with that, they're pretty well going to fit most sizes. I really like those with the clear hearts. Those are one of my favorites. I've made them before with zebra pattern beads. I did some black ones with, I did a daisy chain design on the foot portion of that. I've got these in the red, white, and blue with the star bead. And with ever so often I put colored beads around the ankle portion. Those are really cute at the 4th of July. I've got some here that didn't really have any different beads on the foot portion. Just a straight line of round glass beads in all different colors for those and the glass beads. I've got some more here in plastic beads that I found in the children's section. I think these are really cute. The colored beads here are from this pack here, the glow-in-the-dark beads. And you just leave those out in the sun or under a lamp, and those will gather light, and the colored ones there will glow in the dark. Really cute. Kids have a lot of fun with those. Also, on these, if you'll notice, they just have a just the cording there with no beads on the toe portion. I just used a crimp bead there as a stop for the rest of them and went from there. There's not really a long section for a foot portion, just that one bead, and then it goes off into the two sides. Just for, without a portion on the foot, just a V design, more of a flip-flop kind of look. Personally, I prefer the beaded toe ring part, but some people don't like the bulk of the beads between their toes. It's just your personal preference, however you want to do that. That's why we craft, so we can make it the way we like it. So if you prefer that without the beads around the toe portion, just use a crimp bead there as a stop and do the rest. You know, just include that toe portion in your overall 9-inch measurement, and it should work out just fine. Go ahead and clip off our tails there. I hope you like this video. If you did, be sure and share it so everyone can see how to make beaded barefoot sandals. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Give me a like over on my Facebook page and follow me on Pinterest. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.